work for Siegel Services, and today we're going to learn how to make sandwiches. Now, the first thing you want to do when you're making a sandwich is decide what you want to put in it. And the way to decide that is perhaps if you check your healthy checklist. Now, this is what you should be consuming every day. You should be consuming 2 fruits, 4 grains, 3 vegetables, and 3 proteins. Some examples of grains are bread and rice. Some examples of proteins are peanut butter and meats. So if you can get as much as you possibly can in your decision about what you want in your sandwich, that's ideal to make it a meal. So today, I am going to make myself some peanut butter and jelly. However, I am also going to make a healthier choice for people who are diabetics. Do you know what diabetics means? A person who is diabetic can't eat a lot of sugar because their body can't get rid of it. So if they eat too much sugar, then they could get really sick. This right here, these grains, they turn into sugar in your system. So you have to be careful when you're making decisions. If you are diabetic, you have to make healthier decisions. Okay, so let's get started. I've decided that I'm going to make peanut butter and jelly for myself. Now, what's the first thing you need to do when you're going to work in the kitchen? Wash your hands. I'm going to step away and wash my hands, and I'll be right back. I'm going to dry my hands really well, and they are all clean. Now, what do you think the second thing might be? Well, the second thing might be you want to clean your work area, because you don't want to make a sandwich on a counter that might have had a purse on it or something like that, because then you just get germs. And especially today, we want to be careful about germs. So I'm going to use these disinfectant wipes, and I'm going to clean my counter where I'm going to make my sandwich, just to be sure that it's clean. Make sure we get all of the spots. Okay. Very good. And I think I'll dry it off real quick. And then I'm not a huge fan of making sandwiches directly on the counter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spread this paper towel out so that I have some place to make it. Okay, now what I've already done is gathered my ingredients, and I've also gathered the utensils that we need, because utensils are almost as important as the sandwich, as the makings of the sandwich itself. Okay, so I'm going to get out 2 pieces of bread. This is really cool bread. Look how little it is. Look how skinny it is. It's for people who are trying to be careful about what they eat. So I'm going to make it on this bread, but you can pick out any bread you want to. Probably if you were to stick with a wheat bread, that might be a little bit better than a white bread, but I don't really know about that. Okay, so now I'm going to open my peanut butter, and I'm going to open my jelly. I've chosen currant jelly today, because that's really my favorite. But you can choose any kind of jelly you want to. Then I'm gonna put about a tablespoon on there, and I'm gonna spread it around. I chose this knife because it seems to do spreading really well. Okay, once I have the jelly on there, I'm gonna wipe whatever is off on the other piece of bread, and then I'm gonna get some of this peanut butter. And I'm going to spray the peanut butter on this side. Okay. And I'm going to stick the 2 sides together. And I have made myself a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Okay, now for people who are diabetics, I'm going to choose these wraps. They're Carb Mission wraps, and what that means is there aren't as many carbs or grains in the wrap, so that you're keeping your sugar low if you're diabetic. So I'm gonna lay down another piece of paper towel, and I'm gonna get out one of these. They make tacos out of these too, and they're quite delicious. Okay, so now I'm gonna add the mayonnaise, which I forgot to get out. And I'm gonna get the spreader, which is really good for these wraps. And I'm just gonna spread the mayonnaise on there like that. Okay. And next, I'm going to add, I think I'll add the bacon next because that lays kind of flat. I already pre-cooked this bacon earlier today in the oven. That's why it came out so flat and pretty. Okay, so we're gonna add the bacon like that. And then I'm gonna stick some of this lettuce on top. I like this lettuce because it's already cut up and it has different kinds in it. And it's already pre-washed. You have to remember when you're using vegetables to pre-wash everything. I've already washed this tomato under some water and dried it off, so it's ready to go. You can tell this one isn't washed because it still has a sticker on it. Okay, so next I'm going to cut this tomato with this knife. Be careful about using sharp knives because you know you can cut yourself and then that's very bad. Okay, so I'm gonna cut this tomato. Just like this, I'm gonna put a little tomato on this wrap. Wow, that looks good enough to eat, doesn't it? And I'm gonna put a little more on. Now this wrap has your bacon is your protein and your lettuce and tomato are your vegetable. And then I'm gonna stiff that all in there. And there is my BLT wrap. And we have covered all of the nutritional bases. Thank you and goodbye. Okay, that's all.